Hello everyone, George here, and we're back again with our supply closet and my implementation of FNAF. We're going to work now on at least some of these cylinders, so we should be able to do this pretty quickly and simply. Now, do I have a bottom to these? Let's go to X-ray mode, take a quick look. Yes, I do. So let's work with the more narrow of the bunch, and we'll make, actually, let's go with the wider ones. I guess the more narrow ones might be, I don't know. But anyway, we're going to make some paper towels here. So let's go with these thicker ones. And let's go to Window, Modeling Editor, and UV Editor. Definitely not the distribution of UVs that we want. Let's go to Checkerboard Pattern to see what we have. We can see that the sides here especially aren't terribly well thought out. Let's go to right-click UVs and Shell. Let's grab the top and the bottom. Let's grab the bottom, actually, and move that up. Maybe down over here and grab this one and move it over there and scale both down because it's not going to need that much space, not right now at least. This one's the bottom, so let's move it over there. The top is going to need a lot of space since that's what's going to be visible and seen. So let's actually keep that one up, probably down here. And over here are the sides, and the sides are going to need a lot more space going this way. So let's square them off a bit and have them hopefully begin and end somewhat. Let's see, let's go to arrange and do layout along the U-axis. No, let's do V. There we are. So there's our Vs, and that's relatively okay. It looks like it's just a little tiny bit too big, and we're gonna just bump that up ever so slightly. And now we have that on the lower half. We have the top and we have the bottom. So that's pretty much it for the UVs on this object. Given how much space we actually have free, we might want to put both variations of these cylinders in one texture. I'm trying to think, if we have this much here and we have that and that, it'll be a tight fit to get them all in one. So let's just leave them as separate textures for the moment. So let's go ahead and go to Images, UV Snapshot. Am I in object mode? Nope. F8, images, snapshot, browse, and save this out and call it paper towel. Hit OK. And let's go into Photoshop now and check it out. Maya, images, looks like I spelled it wrong. I'll fix that later. Okay, double click, and let's go to stroke. Good. And let's search for some things really quick. All right, so I've gone online already, and I've searched for a couple images. I like the general texture of this one. Unfortunately, I don't have a top and a bottom yet, but this one gives me a nice color to work with. And I also found this one under paper towel close up to get sort of the pattern. I'm hoping to combine both of these together to create the overall pattern that I want. So let's go ahead and copy this image. Control N, enter Control V. Let's straighten it up using the ruler tool. I'm just going to straighten across this part right now. Image, rotation, arbitrary, okay. And let's cut this apart now so we have something to work with. And I'm not just sampling the color, I'm trying to get an area of it because I do want to work with a larger portion of it as my pattern or texture. Let's do that. Okay, so that's good. So now that I have that working for me, let's fill this in using my spot healing tool up there and down there and off to the side, off to that entire side. And it looks like there's a slight change in coloration up there at the top, so I'm just going to take this entire thing, go to image, image size, and let's make this 1024 by 1024. Now go to filter, other, offset, 512 by 512. Yeah, see the huge difference in the intensity of this image right there? So that's not good. So let's once again duplicate this, control U, desaturate it. Filter blur, Gaussian blur, a lot, and normal, invert that, L, get our ranges a little bit better. I'm gonna blur that again, and let's just overlay this. Maybe take it down to 50%. Merge the layers, filter, other, offset. Still a little bit off, but that's, I think, more my colors than anything. So why don't we grab the coloration? Whoops. Let's grab... Let's escape. Let's get rid of the ruler tool. There we are. Since the top of this is such a problem for me, what do we do? Why don't we just do this? Let's crop this halfway, image size, and then make the other one fit. And then go to filter, other, offset. And you can see in the offset now that we don't have nearly as much of a problem because we've halved kind of the issue right there. But we can still go in here now and just fixing some of that. And I mean, yes, there's some stretchiness to the texture now, but it's not so much. And with the pattern that we're going to work with, that's going to end up taking over most of what's going on anyway. So here's one of the example patterns that we can overlay on top of this. So let's see here. Where's that close up? There we go. So let's copy that pattern. Control N, enter Control V. Let's go to image size, and 2000 is huge. Let's just make that 1024 by 1024, enter, and go to filter, other, offset, 512 by 512, and I don't plan on having the pattern be terribly pronounced, so I'm going to just let it be. Let's go to Control A, edit, define a pattern, and call this paper towel texture. Go here, image size. I'm going to double this to 2048 by 2048. Then go to edit, and let's make a new layer, shift F5, go to pattern, and fill it with this pattern. See, there's a little bit of junk right there, but that's okay because one, the opacity isn't going to be terribly there, and two, we're going to overlay this on top of the existing layer. At least that was the hope, but I'm not getting a whole lot going on here. So let's go to 100% opacity, Control L this. Let's bring the darks in, make it a little bit more pronounced. So you can really start seeing the pattern. Let's overlay that soft light. I'm liking soft light a little bit more. We might want to go in here and fix some of the bad parts of the pattern. For instance, right here. So let's go to this one and turn that off. Zoom in. And it looks like there's a huge gradient going on right there, which is kind of causing me some problems. But let's just see if we can't just try to fake it a little bit. It's a little bit better. And then coming into here now, making a mask and sort of just fading one into the other. And that looks like crap. Can we make this smaller? Then maybe I almost feel like this could probably take a little bit longer to get exactly right. But let's just see what happens if we grab both ones, merge them together now. I feel like I grabbed the wrong section to work with. But it might not really matter that much. Let's go to Control A, Control Shift C, come over here now, grab all of this, and Shift F5, do a pattern. Whoops. Let's go to Edit, define the pattern, and call this paper towel textured. Go to Control D. Let's just Shift F5 the whole thing and do the whole area first, because I think I'm going to want to make some changes. So this is too textured for its size. So actually, let's go to image size. Let's make this 1024, 4x1024. So we get another repeat of the pattern. Control A, edit, define pattern, paper towel texture. And let's Control A the whole thing. Whoops. Other texture. Where is it? Layer, down, UVW, enter, save this out before I lose all my work. And go to FNAF, Photoshop, save, OK. Shift F5, pattern, this one, and hit OK. Because I actually want the pattern to be this way with what I'm doing. And whoops, I put that in the wrong layer, didn't I? Shift F5, OK, rotate that. There we are. Apply. And that pattern still might be too much for what we're doing. I need the tops and the bottoms, but for right now, let's just do this. I'm interested in seeing what it looks like. Once again, just look up stain. I want just some, that's good. That's someone's DeviantArt stuff. Pinterest, what is this? Coffee stains, etc. Not this one, view image. Copy image. Control V. Wow, that's low res, isn't it? And put a gradient on this. We're not a gradient. Let's do a selection, I guess, first. And then we'll do a gradient afterwards. Quick select tool. Something up here. And Shift F5, enter. Shift F5, not pattern. Let's do foreground color. Do that. Take this layer now. Grab the top and fill that in. Now let's go to this, go to filter, and we're going to blur this. So filter, view please, filter, blur, Gaussian blur. I do want to that's why. It looks like I cut it out like a moron. Alright, so I'm stupid. Let's just go in here, paste this back in, and put this up here as well. Apply, move this to the back. Is that in a group? No. Alright. Good enough. Can I do this? Then go to filter, blur, Gaussian blur. Right. Can I turn this off for right now? Let's make a new layer. Put that there. Delete the mask, merge these two layers together, go over here, just heal that crap. Good enough. Take this mask, put it there. Okay, that was a lot of work for something stupid I accidentally did. And now take this and just... give it something. And where are my UVs? Yeah, I don't want this terribly. There. Okay. And really, I guess the whole thing should probably be darkened a bit. That's going to be something I end up doing later on, I suppose. But for right now, I guess it's fine. Let's go UVs off. Oh no, before we do that, let's look up paper towel top. These are interesting. Let's see if we can use this. Control N, enter, Control V. Let's grab this, cut it down to what we need. Enter. And we need to distort this so that this becomes a circle again. Let's go to canvas size and do that first. And play with a few things to begin with. And now let's start playing with stuff. So right click, Control T, right click. I want to put a circle in here first. So if I do this and put a selection circle, that's actually quite circular as it is. The main problem is that this center region is not in the center, so I probably need to do some kind of a warp on this entire thing. To get that where it should be. I'm guessing. If not a warp, then something else. I don't know if this is the right tool for the job. Because what I'm doing seems quite linear. Well, that's definitely not correct. Okay, so yeah, don't apply. Let's try that again. Control T. I think warp is the right tool, but I don't want to warp everything. I just want to warp the center of this. All right. Because I want to keep the circular part on the outside. Now if I grab this and we go outwards and I just kind of grab this, I should be able to pick something. Well, hold on. That's not what I wanted to do. Control D, grab this, make that larger. That's my circle. I want to mask everything else. I want to grab this. I don't want to link these two. And let's go with that. Now, I'm also going to want to fill this in right here. It's not perfect, but I don't think it needs to be. Let's do Shift F5, enter. Put that on top of this one. And let's go to filter, let's grab that, do this, Shift F5 the whole thing, filter, blur, Gaussian, way too big. Okay, overlay, what I want to do, darken, let's go with color burn, all right, get rid of that back stuff, that's confusing me, And Control A, Control Shift C, come back over here. UV's on, Control V. We've got a little bit of a color discrepancy I'm gonna have to deal with. So I'll have to figure that one out. I'm very bad at matching color, so I'll probably screw that one up, but that's not so bad. Apply, Control V, do the same thing again for the bottom. So again, we'll never see the bottom, so it really does not matter. But if you want to, you can take your time and make sure it's perfect. Now really what I should do is, let's see if I can do this. I want to color match this with this. So if I go to here, I get rid of some of these layers, like these ones, and I come here and I go edit, what is it? Image, I go to image adjustments, and I go to match color, and we choose this paper, that's definitely not correct. We choose the correct layer. See how it's pulled the colors in, but I'm not getting... color intensity. I'm getting the colors, but I'm not getting what I want. I'm getting color, but I'm also not getting the right stuff elsewhere, which is kind of pissing me off. But that's kind of what I want to do, is to pull those colors in and make that work. Well, can I do that? Can I grab this layer, do that, and then fix it after by taking this layer and then image, adjustments, match color, choosing this and layer one. That gives us this, which should match the color. Now bringing this layer back in, I can do just a color, just darken, multiply on it, and if I go to Control L and I bring those darks back in, it's a bit much, but if I'm careful in how I control it, I can get something like that. But see, I did lose the brown on that inner paper towel, but Control A, Control C. Let's see what it looks like over here. So it's going to match a heck of a lot closer. Now, that being said, nah, let's try this. Let's go with this newer style as opposed to the other one. Apply, move this one over, scale it down. Scale it up and over, somewhere like that. Okay. There we are. Bring the UVs back for a second. We'll go with it. Turn the UVs off. Let's go to Save, File, Save As, FNAF, Textures, Paper Toweler. Let's put this in the Supply Closet. And we want PNG. Okay. Go inside of Maya. Grab this, right click, assign new material. Fong. Supply. Closet _ paper towel _ M. Grab this, enter, color, file, enter, and place 2D texture, enter, there we are, this, and going up to our textures, supply closet, paper towel, and there we are. That's actually not so bad. There's a little bit of a nastiness right there. But it's not that awkward, really. If we want to, we can, of course, extrude inwards on the top and actually make that part of the geometry. This texture might be a little bit too large. It definitely is too large for what the paper towel is like, but it's still okay. It's not tremendously horrible. So let's go with that for now. Right click, assign existing material. And let's do the paper towel for all of those elements. And of course we need to transfer the UVs of this object to these other ones or duplicate that object. Let's just transfer them. Grab both, go to mesh, and transfer attributes, local UVs, grab you and you, apply, you and you, and hit apply. Great. Okay, so those are our UVs properly transferred across those objects, and that's it for our paper towel. So that's it for this video. If you enjoyed it, of course, give me a like. If you didn't enjoy it, give me a dislike. And as always, if you want more content like this in the future, feel free to subscribe. I will see you in the next video. So long, everyone. Have a great day.